What up, what you guys? You know who it is. It's your boy, John Mike, back again with my man, Chill Will Suddeth, organ extraordinaire. And today we're going to do a shootout between my favorite VST organ, the B-5, and the new kid on the block, the B-3X by Ik Multimedia. So, you know, we was playing around with it before, and we kind of came to some conclusions, I think. But we're gonna bring you guys in on what we do. So first, we're gonna do some just quick audio examples. He's gonna play the B-3X first, and then we're gonna play the B-5 and let you guys kind of hear what they say. We've tried to match the settings, you know, the Leslie and the organ and all of that as best as we can, and we'll talk about that. Let's just jump into it. So we'll start with the B-3X first.
So we full out on all of them.
Yeah, full out.
Uh-oh. You can't do that on a real organ.
Yeah, man. Okay, we're the church. That's what we call churching. All right, now this is the B-5. The crazy thing about it is, and you was saying before, like when you're listening to the B-3X, it's like, when I go back to it, it's like it sounds more like a real Hammond.
That's like a real Hammond. You know,
when you're playing it.
Yeah.
And it sounds good and it feels good when you're playing it.
Yeah.
But it's something about, I don't know, it's just something about the B-5.
The B-5, like they put some oil on it.
Yeah,
it's I don't know. It's a warmth to it.
Yeah,
and it's kind of one of those things. It's almost like a pick game.
You know, you just gotta.
It's like just whichever one you feel in that day. Because I mean, it's, I can't really say one's better than the other. They're both nice. They both have good tone.
Yeah.
They both got good rumble.
Yeah. What's called the B-5, not the B-5, but the B-3X, mm-hmm, was more brighter in tone.
It was brighter.
Yeah, definitely brighter in tone, had a more, you know, brightness to it. And again, we tried to match these Leslie settings as best as we could, and vibrato settings. Like if you go on the speaker preferences here in B-5, we used the 122A.
Right.
We kept the EQ flat. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Nothing done there. 122A here. If I go back up here to the B-3X, and I go over here to cabs, we got the same thing, Leslie amp, 122A, EQ flat. We hadn't changed anything, but it's just the difference in tone.
It's just a difference in tone. It's like going
Both of these are A100s. Make sure we use the A100 model in both of the organs. But it's just something about when you playing that B5 to me. It just has that it's duller. Mm-hmm. It doesn't have that high end, but you can tweak that if you want that high end. You can just go and tweak on the EQ, get some more highs out of it. But something in that mid to low end is just got that power in there.
You know? One you at Mariah Baptist.
Yeah.
And the other one, you at the Citadel of Worship.
Yeah. but that could be a good thing to have both of those in yeah. your arsenal because, you know what yeah. I'm saying, like, we know in the real world, mm-hmm. There is no cookie-cutter organ.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Like, exactly. There's a million churches in the world and a million organs in them, and when you walk into each church, you're going to get a different sound, a different feel. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? They all sound and feel different.
And that's what it is. And that's the beauty of analog instruments.
Yeah.
You know, analog instruments, they may be built with the same parts.
Yeah.
They have the same motion or whatever you got, you know, going on in there, but they all have, you know, you know what it is. Like, you know it's an organ when you hear it.
Yeah.
You know it's a Hammond, but it just, everyone, if it's analog, they all sound
different.
Slightly different.
Because the tube age, you got Leslie types and Leslie, you know, the blades and the Leslie, mm-hmm. they worn mm-hmm. it different things.
That's called the character. That's the character of the organ. It's like, you know, the one organ at your church might be the same one I got in my church, the same Leslie, mm-hmm. the same settings. But there's something different, you know. Of course, you know, the way somebody plays it is different, but there's always something different about the sound. It's like, it sounds a little flatter, but I like it. It sounds a little sharper, but I like it. I don't know what it is, but it's something different.
Yeah.
So, and that's kind of what you're getting with these two organs. So I
can't really comment as
I can't tell. I don't know. I don't know.
Can't pick a winner.
I'm in a lost words, man. They're both nice.
I'd
use both of them.
Yeah, so I think it comes down to that, like preference. If you're trying to decide between one or the other, either cost or your interface, what you kind of want out of it, because the cost wise now they're almost $100 difference. The B-3X is going to run you $199, whereas the B-5 is $99. Mm-hmm. You know, I think euros, but you know, it's like maybe $115, $120, something right there, conversion rates or whatever. But yeah, you're talking about almost $100 difference in price. But so features, you know, you've seen it. If you go watch the B-3X video, and I'll link the acoustic samples B-5 video in the description so you can check that out. But they pretty much have, like, you got stumps, you got in the B-3X, you got different cabinets you can choose through, you got post effects. And then if you jump down to the B-5, you pretty much have the Leslie effects, and then you have, some advanced preferences and some MIDI preferences, but you can tweak a little bit, but you don't have like all of those, you know, stomp effects and things like that. So mm-hmm. it really just kind of boils down to those things.
Well, I think too, I mean, you can look at it from this standpoint. Well, one thing is Ik Multimedia actually uses the Hammond name.
Yeah, they're officially branded.
They're branded. So, you know, that's probably going to be a little extra. But the thing that's cool about theirs is if you just get the Leslie by itself, that's $149.
Yeah. It just really boils down to choice, I guess.
Yeah.
But we just wanted to do that shootout for you guys just to kind of have some people to ask about it and everything. And I knew, and I mentioned in the last video that we were going to do it. So I wanted to make sure that I got that out so you guys could check that out. So it's, you know, you can go back and listen to it again just in character. But that's kind of our approach to it. So that's all we wanted to show you guys. We appreciate you hanging out. Hit the like button, the share button, drop a comment below. Do all those things that you normally do on the video. And if you decide you want to buy this, I got some affiliate links down in the description, all of that good stuff like that. Check them out. And we'll talk to you guys on the next video. Out.
God bless.
Holla at your boy.